So it is April 4th, 2006, and it's my first game coaching baseball ever. I'm in Northeast Seattle Little League, and I'm coaching 13 and 14-year-olds. That's when I started coaching kids like Eli Matthew and Jack Scheidemann. And Joe Marsh.
92.
So it was really a formative time of Driveline. And we really leaned on things like barbell training for baseball athletes was still relatively new. Realized how important strength was in a one-year sample. We really branched out into the overload and underload balls on a whim. Frozen ropes sent my partner the wrong set of weighted balls. And while decrying them, my partner said that we should at least test them. And in doing so, we found out that kids threw way harder after 6 weeks of intervention testing with no loss of internal range of motion. So that's when I knew I'd proved to myself that I was wrong. And I could either stare the evidence in the face and say, yeah, I don't believe in it, or I can accept the new paradigm and get my athletes better.
Okay, 105.8.
Hello, YouTube. Welcome to another edition of the tour of the Driveline Baseball Facility.
We move into another facility. We finally have a facility of our own and really got to build it from the ground up exactly in the vision that I wanted to. So it was really not much in there. There was a fishing net that we had repurposed from the Puget Sound. But we did have some interesting tech that people didn't have at the time, and in some cases we don't have today at our facility now. We had overhead cameras, four cameras that were linked, and we had really started to get into EMG sensor testing. We had started to deploy the Mark Pro based on the results that we were getting from it. We're starting to get other big leaguers now. Ryan Buchter, my first pro client, is now in the big leagues. Caleb Cotham, another one of my first pro clients, is in the big leagues with the Yankees.
That'll be strike three. That'll be the first big league strikeout.
And it starts a domino effect of professional athletes seeing pitchers pass them up that were previously kind of written off. And that's a big part of who we are, and I think a part of who we'll always be. But now today in 2017, we face a different problem, which is how do we kind of address everybody? Because it's very clear today that Driveline Baseball has won the war of unorthodox pitching gurus or pitching companies. So now we have to address enterprise solutions. So how do we package and sell high-speed video solutions to teams and sports science concepts, and how we train athletes and deploy on a wide-scale basis? But the ethos has always been the same, which is we're going to lead in data-driven player development. We are going to write everything down, and we're going to analyze it later, and we are going to do our best to get our athletes the best by knowing the truth. And so it's very cool to say from April 4th, 2006 to the end of 2017 that the mission has not changed, and we're still doing the exact same thing today that we were doing 11 years ago, just with kind of more expensive tools and much better athletes.